Okay, let's look at the review exercise. The probability mass function of a random variable X is given below. Here, these are the possible value. Possible value of X, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And how likely you see those possible value? Probability X equal to 1 is 0.1 plus theta. Probability X equal to 2 is 0.2 plus theta. And so on and so forth. In the test of H naught, theta equal to 0 or theta equal to 0.1. H naught is theta equal to 0. H1 is what? Theta equal to 0.1. Okay? Our decision is we're going to reject H naught if X is 1, 2, 3. Okay? For those given information, we want to find what's the probability of making type 1 error. And B is this is a powerful test. Two questions, okay? Now, having said this is what? A PNF, we need to check probability should add up to what? Probability should add up to 1, right? So let's check, okay? 0.1 plus 0.2, 0.3. 0.3 plus 0.2, 0.5. 0.5 plus 0.1, 0.6. 0.6 plus 0.4 is 1. But there's a theta component. Theta plus theta, 2 theta. 2 theta plus 3 theta, 5 theta. 5 theta minus 1 theta, 4 theta. 4 theta minus 4 theta. Yes, if you add up these 5 numbers, they add up to 1, okay? So this is a legitimate what? A legitimate PNF. And assuming each one, each probability should be greater equal to 0, okay? So, think about this question, okay? We want to find what? Probability of making type 1 error, and is this is a powerful test or not a powerful test, okay? Okay, first one, let's find what's a type 1 error. What's type 1 error? Type 1 error. We call this is what? Alpha. Okay? So in this case, what's alpha? Let's see. Type 1 error, by definition, is under H naught is 2. Okay? Under H naught is 2, but we reject H naught. So under the assumption that H naught is 2, okay? Under H naught is 2. What's H naught? H naught says theta equal to 0. So when theta is equal to 0, why you reject H naught? The decision is reject H naught if X is equal to 1, 2, 3. So X is equal to what? 1, 2, or 3. Okay? So when theta equal to 0, when theta equal to 0, what's X equal to 1? When theta is 0, when this is 0, 0, 0, how likely X equal to 1, 2, or 3? That is when theta is 0, this is 0.1. X equal to 3 is 0.2 because theta is 0. X equal to 3 is what? 0.2 plus 3 theta, but theta is 0, so 0.2. So it's 0.1 plus 0.2 plus 0.2, okay? So this is what? 0.1. Let me write one by one. This is X equal to 1 given theta equal to 0 plus X equal to 2 given theta equal to 0 plus X equal to 3 given theta equal to what? 0. So this one is 0.1 plus theta, but theta is 0. So this is 0.1 plus theta plus 0.2 plus what? Theta plus 0.2 plus 3 theta. But what's theta? Theta equal to zero. So that probability is what? The probability is 0.15, okay? That probability is 0.5. Obviously, x equal to 1 given theta equal to 0. It's 0.1 plus theta, but theta is 0, okay? X equal to theta equal to 0. So 0.2 plus theta, but theta is equal to 0. And then 0.2 plus 3 theta, but theta is equal to 0. So 0.1 plus 0.2 plus 0.2 add up to 0.5. So alpha is what? The probability of making type 1 error is 0.5, okay? Now, in this case, is the test powerful? Okay, we know beta is the probability of making what? Type 2 error. And 1 minus beta is what we call what? The power of the test. Okay, the power. So in this case, what is 1 minus beta? Okay, now we want to find power of the test. Okay, so 1 power is equal to 1 minus beta. But what's beta? Beta is the probability of making what? Type 2 error. And type 2 error is under H naught is false, but you retain H naught, you fail to reject H naught. Okay? Under H naught is false. You should have H naught rejected, but you fail to reject H naught. Therefore, that's a mistake, okay? Now, look at here. One minus this, okay? If I call this is A, I call this is B. Okay, I call A and B. So 1 minus probability A given B is 1 minus, by definition, this is probability A and B over PB. Okay? So this is what? This is PB over PB. That, therefore, that's 1. Okay? That's 1. And minus probability A and B divided by PB. So this difference here is PB. How about the numerator? Look at the picture. This is the one you see in my YouTube video. So this is a sample space. This is A, this is B, okay? From B, you take away what? A and B, okay? From B, you take out this part, okay? So that is what? That is the red shady area, okay? The red shady area is from B, you take away what? You take away A and B. In my YouTube video, I mentioned this. This is what? This is B and A complement. Okay? This is B and go back to read my YouTube video, okay? In probability. So from B, you take away A and B. That is what? That's P, B, and A complement. Okay? And this is a definition of what? This is a definition of, what's this definition? This is probability what? A complement and what? Given B. Okay, so 1 minus probability A given B is what? Is probability A complement over B. But what's A complement? Fail to reject H naught become reject H naught. So this is what? You reject H naught. When what? When H naught is false. When H naught is false, you should have what? H naught rejected. If this probability is very high, very close to one, that means the test is what? More powerful. Okay? That's why we call this is power. Okay? That's why I call this is the power of the test. Let's try one more time. Okay? Power. Power, as discussion here, is under H naught is false, we reject H naught, okay? So when H naught is false, that means when H1 is true. And how, why you reject H naught? Because X equal to 1, 2, or 3, okay? So follow this discussion. X equal to 1, okay? X equal to 1 is 0.1 plus theta. But theta now is 0.1, you plug in 0.1. And x equal to 2 is 0.2 plus theta, but theta now is 0.1, plug in here. And x equal to 3 is 0.2 plus 3 theta, but theta is 0.1. So if you plug in theta equal to 0.1, what do you get? You get 1. That is to say, when h naught is false, how likely you reject h naught? 100% chance you reject h naught. So the test is what? Very, very powerful, okay?